looking towards the city, he grieved and wept over it. Jerusalem, Jerusalem, he tearfully cried out. The fact that he repeats it twice emphasizes the depth of his emotion for it. Now, this could also be seen when he repeated the names of Martha in Luke chapter 10, verse 41, and Paul in Acts chapter 9, verse 4. Knowing Socrates was innocent of the charge of corrupting the youth of Athens, it is said that his executioner wept as he handed him the hemlock. Here, however, the executioner doesn't weep for the condemned. The condemned weeps for the executioners. Truly, the world has never seen such love. What a picture. Jesus Christ, not because Jerusalem would reject them, but because they would not allow him to protect them. How about you? Have you allowed the Lord to do what he desires to do? To place his arm around you, to protect and to comfort you? It's not our shortcomings or our failings that cause the Lord to weep. Rather, it's our failure to allow him to love us that causes his tears to flow. Don't allow another day to go by where you walk away from him, where you reject him. Receive him today as your Lord and Savior, and he will gather you in under the shadow of his wing. And there's no other place where you'll find safety, comfort, and protection.